Our area's most beautiful properties deserve the finest realtors. Meeks Realty Group. We focus on buying and selling residential and commercial properties throughout the tri-state area. Contact Meeks Realty Group online at meeks.us or call 304-440-1101.
The views and opinions expressed on this program do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of 580 WCHS, its employees, or WVRC Media. From the studios of WVRC Media, the country, the United States of America, the state, West Virginia, the city, Charleston. This is the Dave Allen Show on 580 Live. And your host.
What we've got here is failure to communicate.
He's kind of a big deal.
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass, and I'm all out of bubblegum.
Dave Allen.
Hey folks, hey, good Thursday morning to you from the Bar Bar Store Studios. Welcome to the show. Ryan Nicholson is our producer today. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you in part by Thornhill Auto Group, including Thornhill GM Superstore. If you're in the market for a powerful, luxurious, an innovative truck, then come check out the 2024 Chevy Silverado 1500 Crew Cab LTZ and High Country today. Find new roads with the folks at Thornhill. Clerk, come by ThornhillGMSuperstore.com or on the road to total savings at Thornhill Motor Mile, US 119 in Chabotville. We do the show from the Parmar Store Studio. If there's not a Parmar Store near you now, there will be soon. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. Lots to cover this morning. Of course, the big story is this situation with the State Transportation Director, Jimmy Wriston. We're going to get into that a little bit later on in the show, plus Brad McElhenney. He'll weigh in on that from the Capitol. Also, some other things that are going on in state government. We'll cover those with Brad. But right now, I want to welcome into the show, State Agriculture Commissioner Kent Leonhardt. Good morning, sir. Welcome to the show.
Good morning, Dave. It's great to be here. Thanks for having me on.
Thank you for being here. It's been a while since we've had you on. What's new with you, sir?
Well, we're obviously in the middle of a legislative session, but at the same time, we are out there working to promote agriculture, and I'm proud to say it's a great time to be in agriculture in West Virginia. The National Ag Statistics released some figures last week that were great. 1,000 more producers from 2017, when I first took office, to 2022. Red meat production's up over 50%. We've got retail sales. Sales to retailers up 57% in that time frame. Cattle numbers are trending up. Everything's looking great in agriculture, and it's because we have all our partners and at higher education just working together.
And speaking of which, I know that there were some announcements made about some things going on in the realm of higher education, including over at West Virginia State. There's some exciting things going on there as it relates to agriculture.
There's a lot of programs. It's great because you have Parkersburg and WVU and West Virginia State and Potomac all trying to develop agricultural programs. That just shows the enthusiasm that's out there for agriculture in the state of West Virginia. This week is National FFA Week. I visited three schools in the last 2 days and talked to the students, hopefully inspired them to continue. Even if they don't stay in agriculture when they leave those programs, they'll be educated consumers. But the neat thing about it, Dave, is we have a record number of students enrolled in FFA in West Virginia of all times.
That's awesome. I mean, it really is. And I think when you go in and you talk to these students, Mr. Commissioner, I think that you tell them, look, you don't just have to be a farmer. I mean, not there's anything wrong with farming, but there are other ways you can get paid, have a good living in the agriculture community.
Oh, absolutely. Look at some of the economic development we've brought in since I've been commissioner, like Mountaintop Beverage up in Morgantown that's doing aseptic milk processing and creating 300 jobs that helped fill that void when we lost Milan. Farmers markets have tripled. We're working with nonprofits like the Food and Farm Coalition and the Farmers Market Association, and farmers markets have almost tripled since I've been in office. There's a lot of different things. We've got research, you've got chemists, you've got microbiology, you've got economic development, and you've got agritourism. Mm-hmm. You can't forget that, too.
So that's a big thing right now. Agritourism is becoming a big thing across America.
It sure is becoming a big thing. And, you know, I like to tout a little bit about, you know, what makes tourism in West Virginia so wonderful. It's our clean waters and our beautiful forests, and your Department of Agriculture plays a big part in that.
Talking again with State Agriculture Commissioner Kent Leonhardt, you mentioned the session. What have you been keeping an eye on as far as the session goes?
Well, we're working on trying to get some truth in labeling things going to make sure that people know what they're eating, you know, because a lot of people are worried about the cell-based meats and things of that nature. We hope that gets through the legislature. Obviously, the budget's always a big concern. And we're also trying to make sure that we do something on protecting our farmlands from foreign lands. I know that's a big thing. It wasn't long ago when everybody was touting about China coming in and the oil and gas industry. I was one of the state leaders that was not in favor of that. And fortunately, it did not happen. But now we're trying to get some things codified. Our bill proposal uses Trump's executive order, just listing those countries that are on the terrorist state to make sure that they can't come in and buy lands in West Virginia.
There is a lot of concern about that. Matter of fact, Commissioner, I was reading an article about that the other day about China coming in and buying up, as you said, at one time it was considered to be oil and gas. Now it's farmland that they're targeting.
That's correct. Fortunately for West Virginia, I've checked, we don't really have any of that going on right at this time, but we want to make sure we're wary of that. You know, there's other states that are bigger in agriculture that are more, a greater target. I've checked in with to see where the industries are doing their research, and there's folks that want to make sure their research is protected because some of the foreign companies do research right here, and we want to benefit from that as well. It's a very complicated issue. We don't want to take a person's property rights away from who's selling to whoever they want, but we also want to make sure we protect agriculture. Very complicated. I don't know if we're going to get that across the finish line this year. I tried last year to get it across. Something stopped it. We're trying again this year.
There's been some debate of course, it's under the dome, but also it's been talked about in the media as it pertains to this whole raw milk thing. Do you have an opinion on that? You're a farm guy. I mean, I don't completely understand it myself, but do you have an opinion on that?
Well, my opinion on it is that people have a right to choose. And if they want to drink raw milk, let them go drink. Let them drink raw milk. But they need to know what they're getting into.
Right.
People do get sick from raw milk. It does need to be properly labeled. And there should be some things on the label that tells when the milk was produced and what the shelf life is and how it should be marketed. I prefer to use the old pasteurization myself.
It's worked for a long time.
It's worked for a long time. But there are people that are passionate about
it.
And they should pursue their passions.
But just be careful on how you do it.
Be very careful.
State Agriculture Commissioner Kent Leonhardt is here with Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you part by Brightway Insurance, the Mays Agency of Taze Valley. Brightway offers up to $2 million in life insurance from all the top carriers in about 10 minutes with a 95% approval rate and no medical exam. See them for all the details. Start a quote today at brightwaymays.com. Commissioner, big happenings this weekend. Saturday, to be exact, the annual Winter Blues Farmers Market happening 1 till 6 at the Coliseum Convention Center. So talk about that.
Well, this is a great event that we have every year. It's getting bigger and bigger every year. And I want to assure those that showed up last year, we had so many people come in, it was very crowded and it was tough to get through. So the space has been expanded. The aisles are wider. We hope you have a better it was a great experience for everybody. We had record sales, and we hope to break those records again this year. But it should be a little bit better of experience during the high times. And we also extended it an hour for this year's show. We tie it in with the Small Farms Conference, where we bring people in and we teach them how to do a small farm in West Virginia. We do this with one of our partners at WVU Extension, and it works out great every year. So proud to be hosting this again this year.
I want to switch gears here for a moment. You have announced, sir, that you will be running for re-election as Agriculture Commissioner. You have at least two other opponents that I'm aware of. Why should the voters of West Virginia re-elect Kent Leonhardt as State Agriculture Commissioner?
Well, obviously, I'm already proven. I kept agriculture open during COVID, which was no small chore.
Exactly.
Our stores were fuller than our neighboring states. I talked to these ag commissioners. My peers elected me to be the president of the Southern Association of State Departments of Agriculture. Big states. How cool is that? West Virginia, not a big ag state as like Georgia, Florida, Texas, gets elected by those individuals to be the Southern. We did that in 2022. I'm currently vice president of the Southern U.S. Trade Association, again, elected unanimously by my peers. And in 18 months, if reelected, I'll be the president. Now, we don't do a lot of foreign trade, but I want to be able to invite food processing into the state like we did with Mountaintop Beverage. And I know others that want to come to the state. We're going to be working on that. And I can look them in the eye and say, if you want to get into foreign trade and help the economy in West Virginia, I can help you. If I sit back and don't do those type of things, we'll never get anywhere. So that's some of the reasons why they should reelect me. And again, we talked about the statistics. It's growing. Even though I don't run FFA, our numbers are growing in FFA because we're partnered with all those, the schools, Department of Education, the USDA, got great working relationships with them. I've testified before Congress on chronic wasting disease, getting those studies improved. There's an awful lot of things that I do at the national level. And currently, I am chair of the Rural Development and Financial Security Committee of the National Association of Departments of Agriculture. So we're very much involved. We're very much engaged. We're moving West Virginia agriculture forward. That's why I'm going to ask everybody to reelect Kent Leonhardt.
You know, something that just occurred to me. We'll let you go on this one on kind of a high note here. When that first Board of Public Works meeting comes up on January 2025, it's going to be interesting because there's going to be a new governor one way or the other because Governor Justice is term limited out, new Secretary of State, Auditor, Treasurer, Attorney General. All those are going to be new people in those positions. That makes you the veteran, sir, so that means you're in charge, right?
Well, it doesn't make me in charge. The new governor will be leading those meetings, but that's one of the decisions I made to stay in agriculture and be commissioner so that we do have somebody that's with experience that are sitting on that Board of Public Works.
All right. Ag Commissioner Kent Leonhardt, always a pleasure to have you on the show, sir. Good luck with everything, including the big event at the Coliseum and Convention Center this weekend. We'll talk again soon. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Dave.
It is 9:18. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you in part by Bridge Valley. If you're interested in improving your company's IT workforce, you may want to know that Bridge Valley offers custom-tailored IT training to bridge the skills gap. At Bridge Valley, you can train for little or no cost with a 50-50 salary match. Bridge Valley can also supply skilled graduates and apprenticeships for your company. Visit them, bridgevalley.edu/apprenticeships today. We're going to talk to Brad McElhenney next. We're back after this from the Parmar Store Studio in the Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Are you a physical therapy assistant and looking for an opportunity in orthopedics, wellness, and athletic care? If so, Generations Physical Therapy is offering flexible work hours and an upbeat atmosphere. With 7 convenient locations, Generations may have a job designed for you. Visit GenerationsPT.com.
Hi, I'm David McCormick, owner of Omega Commercial Interiors. We'd like to thank you, West Virginia, for making us the number one office furniture and commercial interiors company in West Virginia. Remember, when you're looking for quality office furniture and space planning for healthcare, corporate offices, or even a private office, call us and buy local. Omega Commercial Interiors. We're a proud West Virginia company. Visit us online at OmegaCommercialInteriors.com in Morgantown and Charleston.
If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon. You hear us say that a lot, but it's true. Wherever you may go, chances are you'll find a Parmar store there, offering everything you need to get you in and then back on the road as soon as possible. From gas to groceries and snacks and items for your house, we have it at Parmar Stores. Download the app and sign up for the Parmar Rewards Card too. West Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, Maryland, Pennsylvania, and Virginia. If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
We are professional grade. Are you looking for a new truck or SUV that can handle any terrain or challenge? Then you need to visit Thornhill GM Superstore on the Thornhill Motor Mile. Right now, you can get a $6,000 purchase allowance when you trade an eligible vehicle on the new GMC Sierra 1500. Or shop Thornhill's great selection of GMC terrain. You can enjoy 1.9% APR for well-qualified buyers on the small SUV that offers GMC Pro Safety Plus. Plus, you'll get a $500 purchase allowance and no payments for 90 days. Click or come by ThornhillGMSuperstore.com or on the Thornhill Motor Mile, US 119, Chapmanville. So, after GMI, you'll see for all details.
.921 Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline 304-345-5858 Fruit Pharmacy Text 304-935-5008. The Dave Allen Show and 580 Live is brought to you in part by Morgan and Morgan. With more than $20 billion recovered, they believe that when you're injured, you deserve more. Morgan and Morgan, America's largest injury law firm. We're going to get into this Jimmy Wriston situation coming up a little bit later on. But right now, I want to welcome into the show from the state capitol, Brad McElhenney. Brad, good morning. How are you?
Oh, hi, Dave. I've got to keep it short because the House Finance Committee has taken up some pay raises. I'm hoping to hear your name and mine.
Well, that ship sailed with me when I ceased being a state employee a couple of years ago, so I am going to only keep you on here just for a little bit. A couple of quick things. Did you happen to hear the show yesterday with Greg Thomas? If not, go back and listen to it, because he went after this legislative session, and the term lackluster has been thrown about. He apparently thinks it's been a lackluster session. Brad, does that surprise you coming from Greg?
You know, he is politically aligned with many of the people in charge of the legislature and the chambers and who make decisions about the session. So it does, and that actually gives it some credibility with me. I will say my thought is always that the legislature is not here to entertain us. And frankly, there is an entertainment factor, because these are political figures, and catching the public's attention is an aspect of what they do. I will say that a lot of when we say it's just between me and you, when we say it's boring, what we mean is, I mean, they're doing things, but it's just not stuff that really catches the eye, not stuff that captures the imagination. It's just, you know, boilerplate, run-of-the-mill stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And in between all that is, you know, things that are, you know, red meat issues or things that are more high in conflict. And so I would tend to agree that there's been not a lot of ambition, not much that has been imaginative or inspiring out of this session. But to say they haven't been doing anything, which I don't think is the claim Greg made, but to say they haven't been doing thing is, you know, not entirely fair. Let me read to you. Let me just get rid of all your listeners. They're gonna their eyes will glaze over. Let me read you the things up for passage today in the Senate.
Yeah. Okay.
Establishing accreditation deadline for convention and visitors bureaus, revising service obligations for certain doctoral medical degree programs, continuing and updating Board of Risk and Insurance Management, clarifying compensation for county tax collector. So those are examples, and they're doing things, but they are not necessarily the things that capture the public imagination.
You're right. Brad McElhenney's here. I know you're on a time crunch, but I did want to ask you about this. You had alluded to this, and I read the story at WVMetroNews.com, that there could be a big honor coming for the late, great Woody Williams. Talk about that.
Yeah, every state gets two people to honor at the U.S. Capitol in Statuary Hall. One of your regular listeners, Derek Evans, may be aware of the contents of Statuary Hall and the kind of respect that is deserved by those honored there. There are two statues by West Virginia Francis Pierpont, who was founding father of the state, as well as John Kenna, who was a political figure from West Virginia, both in Congress and in the U.S. Senate in the late 1800s. States can differ up who they put to honor there. And Woody Williams, who died 2 years ago, America's last living U.S. Medal of Honor recipient, mm-hmm. is well-deserving, admired just across the board by people, both for his World War II heroics as well as his work to honor veterans in the years after that. So the Senate resolution is going to potentially switch out the John Kenna statue for a Woody Williams statue, and it would be there in perpetuity, not only for West Virginians to admire, but more broadly for people who enter the U.S. Capitol under routine, calm, and approved conditions to also admire.
Finally, Brad, before we let you go, the Jimmy Riston story. And I'm going to talk about it in detail for the biggest part of the rest of the show. Lead story, WVMetroNews.com. Again, I've got a lot more information I want to get out there to the public about this. But from the surface, before we let you go and listen to budget hearings, Brad, what are you hearing from the Capitol?
You know, I think it's wait and see. And in fairness, that is probably appropriate. We do know that Secretary Riston was pulled over for some reason. The initial call was described as erratic driving on mm-hmm. Charleston's East End. The pullover was actually shortly outside of that on I-77, apparently a state vehicle was involved, and it was maybe 11 o'clock at night. So typically that would be after hours, even for a secretary. And we finally know that the Charleston police are having a look at their procedures. So they're scrutinizing themselves. And beyond that, you know, we don't know if it was, if a blood alcohol test was administered. It's always possible that somebody could be having like a low blood sugar situation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It could be that nothing was going on at all. We just don't know yet, but Wriston has been a high profile member of the Justice Administration because people care about their highways.
Sure.
So, you know, everybody's kind of waiting to see what we can find out that is bankable information,
mm-hmm.
you know, information you can trust. And we just don't, for the most part, we don't have that except for the basic outline.
All right. Brad, go and enjoy the rest of your day at the Capitol. I know you will.
If you are up for a raise, Dave, if there's a bonus or any more money being changed to your hands through mm-hmm. an act of state law,
uh-huh.
I will let you know.
Probably not going to happen, but okay. All right, Brad, I appreciate it, man. We'll talk soon. Thanks a lot. Brad McElhenney, again, from the Capitol. It's 928. West Virginia Enriched, in collaboration with Huntington, invites you to witness the transformative power of Special Olympics. Take a few minutes to be inspired and join the collective effort in making a difference. Not just a story, it's a movement of hope, inclusivity, and triumph, reminding us all that every individual deserves a chance to shine. In West Virginia and beyond, Huntington is truly making a difference right here at home. See a video highlighting the Special Olympics at facebook.com/580WCHS. Hey, the rest of the show is yours. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline, 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you in part by your hometown baseball team, the Charleston Dirty Birds. Enjoy all the fun this season at Gilmart Ballpark with the Dirty Birds full season plan. Get tickets to every home game, 10% off at the Dirty Birds team store, a buffet available Monday through Wednesday for home games, and get yourself in the running for giveaways too. Visit DirtyBirdsBaseball.com or the Dirty Birds social media pages there for more information. Text, going back to the interview I did with Ag Commissioner Kent Leonhardt, text said, ask him if pasteurized milk will still be available, or we all have to drink raw milk now, says a texter. I thought the commissioner answered it pretty well, because he's a farmer, and I just, you know, I said, what do you think about it? He said, well, you know, some people like the whole raw milk thing. So some people, like me, it's, you know, kind of silly, but, you know, to each their own, as long as you do it safely, ain't none of my business. Hoppy's back at the Capitol at 10:06 this morning. Among the guests today, Matt Rohrbach out of Kanawha County, the Deputy House Speaker. Delegate Joey Garcia is on the show today. Again, he'll also have more of the Jimmy Wriston story. Commissioner Leonhardt and Brad, who you just heard on this show, will actually make return appearances on Hoppy coming up at 10:06 from the AARP broadcast location from the state capitol. Okay, so let's get into the Jimmy Wriston story. And quite frankly, I'll be honest with you, it is kind of a bizarre story. When it first broke yesterday morning, and even the way that this story broke was kind of strange within itself. I'll get to that here a little bit later on. So it looked like a simple story yesterday. And again, everything I'm saying are all allegations. Everybody's innocent until proven guilty. Let's please throw that out there now to keep the lawyers happy and whatnot. But you know, someone has perhaps being the key word, a little too much to drink, attempts to drive, drives erratically, and is pulled over. Sadly, it happens all the time. But it is a little different when your name is Jimmy Wriston and you are the state transportation director, and you're driving a state vehicle. So let's review. A call to Metro 911 late Tuesday night at around 11 o'clock or so had said that witnesses or the person that called had seen someone in a state vehicle driving erratically on the east end of Charleston. So Charleston police were dispatched, and Jimmy Wriston was stopped on 77 near Leon Sullivan Way. And according to the statement that was released by the Charleston PD, the driver was identified as State Transportation Director Jimmy Wriston. Now, the release said he was not charged or cited at the time. Now, here is where it gets a little interesting. Originally, it was thought that the person who called 911 to report the erratic driving was an off-duty police officer. Well, it was later learned that that wasn't the case, and that the person who made the call to 911 was not, in fact, a police officer at all. Now, this came out like late last night. And in the big picture of things, folks, you know, it shouldn't matter who reported it. But it does matter if said person is misidentifying themselves as a police officer. Now, I'm not an attorney. I heard Tom Payton, the Ask a Lawyer segment with Jeff last hour, talking a little bit about it. But if you call 911 and you identify yourself as a police officer, as I think this person did, and again, this story is changing right up to the minute, then that's a crime in and of itself. Now, the governor addressed the situation during his presser yesterday, and with all due respect to our governor and candidate for state Senate, he didn't get the story totally right himself. The governor alluded to Mr. Wriston being allowed to drive away once it was determined that no charges were going to be filed. That part of it, in fact, according to my sources, and I did a little digging on this myself, that apparently was not the case. Now, I spoke with someone last night, completely off the record, but someone who is close to the investigation, who told me that Mr. Wriston did not drive away, and that, in fact, someone came to pick him up, and I'm supposing someone else came to drive his vehicle away. So that part of it in the initial reporting, or at least what the governor said in the presser yesterday, was incorrect. That's the way it looks right now. New information has become available because originally, again, it was stated that the police officer investigated and the police officer just let him drive away. That's what the governor said. Well, apparently that wasn't the case. That someone came and picked him up, drove his car to wherever, the state car, by the way, it is a state car, to where it needed to go. So the media in the Charleston area was alerted to this yesterday after receiving emails, photos, and videos from the traffic stop. Not from the police, but from someone that alerted the media in Charleston about this yesterday. Now, an internal investigation has been launched by the Charleston Police Department as to whether or not proper police procedure was followed in allowing Mr. Wriston to leave with no charges being filed. Now, I'm told, for what it's worth, I'm told by my source that Mr. Wriston did not try to play the "do you know who I am" card, as many in the public eye have done in the past and will continue to do, but apparently that wasn't the case from what I'm told. In fact, I'm told, again, off the record, that the police actually had no idea who he was and just were following up on the 911 call, and they did not know who he was. There's still a lot of explaining to do with this story. He was, apparently, the driver apparently was driving erratically, perhaps intoxicated,
Important to note, no charges were filed. And it was in a state vehicle after hours. Now, as I alluded to in talking to Brad, I was a state employee for a time. And they pounded upon us the usage of state vehicles or even how to behave when we're on the clock, when we're driving our own personal vehicles or a rental car or whatever the case may be. Of course, let's be fair, I was never to the level of transportation director. far from being anything. I had a title in an office, but that was pretty much it. This story, though, again, is just plain weird. I mean, it's not Commissioner Kent Carper in a park story weird, but it is weird nonetheless. And it is an ever-evolving story. As I said, it just broke yesterday, about 24 hours or so ago, and then the governor had the presser, which kind of mucked things up a little bit. And then late last night, Charleston Police Department comes out with a release. And then later last night, they came out with another release. So apparently what they are doing is they are going to investigate themselves as to whether or not proper procedure was followed in the case. It is very important to remember, folks, and again, not a lawyer, don't play one on TV or even the radio. It is very important to remember that no charges were filed in this case. None, zero, zilch. So that's kind of where we are right now. Jeff has a story, and I think Jeff will probably have more stories and more stories posted, as will all the media in Charleston. Ours, of course, is the most important, WVMetroNews.com, but all of us, are on the story, and we'll give you more information as it becomes available. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you in part by Pinnacle Consultants. Whether you're replacing a roof, remodeling a kitchen, or replacing a bathroom, to keep it safe and to keep it legal, get with Pinnacle Consultants. They can inspect your site, collect samples, perform lab analysis, and provide results, usually within about a week, testing all renovations for mold, asbestos, and lead. It is the law in West Virginia. With PinnacleCorp.net, get with them. PinnacleCorp.net, because what you don't know can hurt you. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. Man, we have got a ton of texts to get to, as I figured would be the case. Plus, I got some information about some things going on in the Senate or the legislature in general I want to get to. Plus, speaking of bizarre stories, and this is one that our sister station is all over, our sister station 987 The Mountain Wild Wonderful Classic Rock. Place that lets me hang out with them from time to time as well. You know, Hooters in Kanawha City has been closed now since 2020 and just didn't survive COVID. Well, the building itself is about to be torn down, and some folks are going to do a candlelight vigil tomorrow night. And this thing started out as being tongue-in-cheek. Well, guess what? It's a nationwide story now. It is now an international story. The London Times is covering this story about the Hooters in Kanawha City being demolished and the candlelight vigil being held there tomorrow night. I'm going to talk about that a little bit later on, but I got to get to some text, and we'll get to those right after this from the Parmar Store Studio on the Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Brought to you by the Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses. Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses care for your family.
Thrive with Five at the best community bank in the Kanawha Valley, Poca Valley Bank. Poca Valley Bank is now offering a certificate of deposit special, 10-month APY, annual percentage yield 5%. Take advantage of this great rate to grow your savings. For more information, stop by a Poca Valley Bank location today or call 844-782-2651. Poca Valley Bank, where relationships matter. Certain terms and conditions apply. Rates based on minimum annual percentage yield. Subject to change without notice. Minimum deposit required of $10,000 of new money not currently on deposit with Poca Valley Bank to receive APY. Member FDIC.
Spring is right around the corner, and Walker Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram and Hurricane is ready to help you upgrade your ride just in time for the change in seasons. Walker has some big-time savings going on this month to help you get ready for the warmer weather. Check out Jeep Gladiators with up to $14,000 off MSRP. Walker also has the largest selection around of the Jeep Grand Cherokees you can't find anywhere. Not to mention, Ram trucks are stocked deep and ready to move with up to $10,000 off new 1500 crew cabs. And just when you thought the deal vehicles couldn't get any sweeter. Gene and Ryan loaded down the pre-owned lot and then marked them all down. Not only are there great prices, but it's a huge selection you'll find in Walker, including Toyotas, Hondas, Chevys, Fords, and anything else you could possibly want. And don't forget, Walker is still buying cars too. So as spring approaches, take that short 20-minute drive from Charleston or Huntington for the best deals around at Walker Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Just off the Hurricane exit of I-64, Walker Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, making friends one deal at a time.
Do you support Donald Trump? Dwayne Duncan, the America First Republican running for Kanawha County Commission, does. Dwayne Duncan is a conservative that will defend our values. Dwayne Duncan is 100% pro-life and a member of the NRA. Dwayne Duncan wants more jobs, safer communities, and a better future for our families. Dwayne Duncan is not a career politician and will fight for all of us. Let's vote for Republican Dwayne Duncan for Kanawha County Commission.
Paid for by Dwayne Duncan for County Commission. Tori DeCubo, Treasurer.
Seventeen minutes away from 10. Phone calls to the show and service of Biggly Piggly Wiggly when shopping at your Biggly Piggly Wiggly. Be sure to join their loyalty program. You can save big at the gas pumps and throughout the store with their electronic coupons and free gifts on Fridays just for stopping by from farm to table. Biggly Piggly Wiggly, the best-kept secret in Charleston. Texting services provided by Fruith Pharmacy. Find the perfect over-the-counter hearing aid at Fruith with Nuvomed hearing aids. Plus, Fruith makes it easier to transfer your prescription service to them. Fruith is and has been your hometown family pharmacy for a long, long time. Tex says, Dave, will the mayor of Charleston be on the show today? No. No. Tex says, nothing is going to happen to Jimmy Riston. The guy is pretty much Teflon. He awarded no-bid jobs to a family member's construction firm. Nothing happened. He's alleged to have ignored an alleged sexual assault by his cousin, who's a boss in the DOT. Nothing happened. He has nepotism in his office. Nothing's gone on. And now this, nothing will happen. He's coated in Teflon, says a texter. Keep in mind, all those are allegations. Tex says, it's so cool that in 2024, we'll go back to child labor, drinking poisonous milk, creationism, and no vaccines, says a texter. Going back to the Kent Leonhard interview, texter says, China buys West Virginia coal exports. Does the ag commissioner not care about this? Tex says, the scanner traffic from the Riston traffic stop is quite interesting. If the news is able to obtain, Riston was followed for some time, says it. And, you know, and I don't really know what to make of this story. I mean, when I first, I'm like a lot of you probably, when I first heard it 24 hours or so ago, I thought, well, okay, you know, this not, it's an unfortunate situation. It's happened. But then when the story comes out, okay, the person is not a police officer that said that they were. I mean, it just, it all seems, the whole story itself just seems a whole lot more than just someone, and I'm not trying to diminish what is being alleged here, that someone had a few drinks, perhaps had a few drinks and drove. The governor actually said that yesterday. It just seems like there's a whole lot more to this story. I mean, I don't know, maybe I'm not a conspiracy theory kind of guy. But it just seems to me like there may be a whole lot more to this story. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you in part by General Hardware and Lumber of Winfield. From kitchens to paints to decks, straight framing wood, roofing metal, anything else you may need, you'll find it at General Hardware and Lumber of Winfield. Texas Dave, the Jimmy Riston incident is really a sad lack of integrity from the Charleston Police Department, especially just after we get a new police chief who has promised to clean things up. Hard to trust yet another internal CPD investigation. The governor and mayor's office both owe the public some more honest explanations. And as always, I have a pretty good relationship with the city of Charleston. the mayor and I don't always agree on everything, but we've been friends long before she became mayor, and we can talk about things. But I say that to say this, I have an open door policy here on this show. And anybody that wants to go on this show from the Charleston Police Department, from the mayor's office to the governor's office, all are welcome here. All are welcome. I'll put anybody on the show. All they got to do is ask. So I will send an open invitation out to
And I understand that they cannot say certain things because they don't want to risk an investigation. I get that. But I have an open invitation to anybody, and the people in the city know that, and the people in the governor's office know that. I've had the governor on the show before. I've had members of the governor's staff on the show. All you got to do is reach out to me. I ain't hard to find. I'm the most visible guy around. I'm not hard to find. So anytime anybody wants on the show, they are more than welcome. Back to the legislature. The House yesterday passed a bill that would allow teachers and other staffs to carry guns if they choose to. Now, the bill passed 89-11 yesterday after an hour or so of debate. It'll now head to the Senate. A lot of back and forth on this one, as you may expect. It was the Democrats primarily against it and the Republicans for it. Delegate Kaylee Young from here in Kanawha County was no vote, citing her fears of safety. A delegate Anitra Hamilton from Monongalia County, a delegate Sean Hornbuckle of Cabell County spoke out against it. One of the folks who spoke for it was Delegate Dave Foggin out of Wood County, who himself was a high school teacher. The teachers and staff would have to undergo training to be able to carry if they choose to. And getting back to Delegate Hornbuckle, he asked, what if the gun were to accidentally be left lying around somewhere? He used example, teacher, sets it down to go help another teacher with something or to run to the restroom or whatever the case may be. Still a lot of unanswered questions in this. The debate will continue, but again, for now, it has passed the House and will now head to the Senate. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you in part by Live Healthy West Virginia, presented by WVU Medicine. Live Healthy West Virginia tackles pressing health issues like disease, diabetes, Alzheimer's, and more. The podcast offers insights into medical breakthroughs and preventative care, featuring WVU Medicine's expert physicians, aimed at fostering healthier lifestyles and beyond in the state. It's a valuable resource for all. Discover the latest episodes on WVMetroNews.com under the podcast menu and start your journey towards better health today. Texas Dave, city police have been ticketing cars like crazy on the boulevard near the Moose. Was the state worker ticketed? Drivers on the boulevard were. There were no citations issued. And if you're referring to the Jimmy Risen situation, no citations were issued, as far as I know. I hope you had a chance to hear the show yesterday. And if not, I would urge you to please go back, as I always do. I always urge you to go back and check the podcast. You can get it from your favorite podcast provider. Sign up for it. It'll be delivered directly to your email. Or you can go to WCHSnetwork.com or the social media pages of the stations or my personal social media. I had Republican strategist Greg Thomas on the show yesterday, and he was calling out at least a little the legislature. Brad and I talked about it a little bit earlier. I'll be honest. When Greg first reached out to me and said he wanted to talk about the lackluster performance, his words, lackluster, of the legislature this session, I thought, to be honest with you, I thought maybe he was being just a little facetious. It turns out, though, he was serious. And the one thing I have learned about Greg Thomas when having him on this show off and on for the last 4 years or so is that just when you think you've got him figured out, he goes in the opposite direction. And he does. He's his own guy. I mean, he really, really is. Did you happen to catch his disdain for Patrick Morrissey, who is now the leading candidate for governor? A texter on the show yesterday asked Greg point blank who he was supporting for governor, and he just came out and said, anyone but Patrick Morrissey. That's what he said. And it's not like that was the first time that he had said something like that. Anyway, Mr. Thomas had sent me one of what he called, the top 10 reasons for the lackluster session, kind of going all David Letterman with the top 10 list. And I'll give you just a couple of them in case you missed it yesterday. One, a lame duck governor. And again, as he pointed out, that is not the fault of Governor Jim Justice. He is a lame duck governor because he is term limited out by state code. So he's done regardless, and he's going to run for state senate, and something major changes, he's going to win. So that's part of it, according to Greg. The constitutional office holders, the Attorney General, Secretary of State, all of those are all running for other offices, all except the Ag Commissioner, who you heard from earlier, Kent Leonhardt. So they, I'm not saying that they're not doing their jobs, because I'm sure they are, but Riley Moore is running for something else. J.B. McCuskey's running for something else. Mack Warner's running for something else. Leonhardt's the only one that's left in that room. So that's one of the reasons, Greg's words. He referred to a fractured, unprofessional, socially conservative agenda. Ding, ding, ding. We have a winner there, Alex, in my opinion. You get the point. I would urge you to go back and listen to Greg's appearance on the show yesterday. Must listen to radio. Matter of fact, we even made a promo out of it yesterday with some of the words that Greg. That's how you know it's good. And Ryan will tell you, that's how you know it's good, is when we make a promo out of it. And we did, and it's running as a promo for the show. I'm using Greg Thomas for my own benefit. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you in part by Meeks Realty Group, as a locally owned real estate powerhouse. They specialize in residential and commercial properties. No property too big or too small for Meeks. With their team of the finest realtors in the business, Meeks Realty Group is your trusted partner in finding your dream home or your dream commercial investment. Call them today, 304-440-1101, or visit meeks.us. We're back after this from the Parmar Store Studio on the Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Brought to you by the Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses. Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses have been creating jobs in West Virginia since 1997.
Coach Pruitt here. I want to share some information about Forest Carbon Credits, or FCCs. FCCs are a great way for landowners with timberlands to earn money in between harvests. Landowners now have another choice for earning additional income. And the West Virginia Forest Resource Coalition is working to protect this fundamental right. For more information on FCCs, please visit wvforestresources.org.
Paid for by the West Virginia Forest Resources Coalition.
My wife and I both, we ended up mildly sick for a few months, and the nasal congestion was probably the worst part. I had like a post-nasal drip, just super congested all the time. We were taking everything we possibly could, but nothing really worked.
Kyrie was miserable until a friend recommended Navage. Navage offers immediate drug-free congestion relief, flushing your nasal passages with refreshing saline and sucking out mucus, germs, and other airborne irritants. Don't live in misery this cold season. Use Navage so you can breathe easier, sleep better, and feel your best right away.
The biggest thing Navage has done has completely cleaned out my nasal passages. It was from the first use. I was able to just clear out anything that was stopping me from breathing correctly. Navage helps me clear the way, literally clear the way, for me to operate better in the rest of my life.
Experience the Navage difference yourself. Navage is available at Navage.com or at Walmart, Walgreens, CVS, and Rite Aid. Navage, N-A-V-A-G-E.
Pizza's here.
Oh, great. I'd love some, but I'm worried about my stomach issues.
If you're worried about having diarrhea, gas, bloating, stomach pain, or loose, oily stools, it may not just be stomach issues. It could be a condition called exocrine pancreatic insufficiency, or EPI. With EPI, the pancreas doesn't release enough enzymes to break down food, but EPI is manageable. Use the symptom checker on identifyepi.com and talk to your doctor. That's identifyepi.com. Sponsored by AbbVie.
It's 5 away from 10, the Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you by Hudson's Pizza. It is heart-shaped pizza time again. Get a 14-inch small heart-shaped pepperoni pizza, $14.99 all month long. Find your nearest location, hudsonspizza.com. Texas Dave, this legislature has done nothing to increase revenue this session. All the federal money this state received is going to run out eventually. As a conservative Republican state, West Virginia shouldn't rely on federal funding to fund the state government. Texas says, I hope Steve Williams, reference to the Huntington mayor who is running for governor, hope Steve Williams runs on not being a rubber stamp for the ridiculous Republican legislators. We need some checks and balances at the Capitol, says a texter. Texas Dave, we need a resource officer in every school, period. Not teachers having such a heavy responsibility of carrying a gun in school. Our lawmakers need to fund the funding for this. Thanks, says a texter. Texter says, isn't it funny that drag queens are dangerous, but deadly weapons are safe around kids, according to the GOP? I think many in the GOP are scared they'd be attracted to drag queens and need a tool to compensate for their shortcomings, says a texter. From the tongue-in-cheek department, Now, this story first surfaced earlier this week. As you know, the Hooters restaurant in Kanawha City has been closed since 2020 and is going to be torn down, the building itself. It's set empty for some time. A couple of guys locally, Leo Browning and Drew Cook, wanted to pay tribute to one of their favorite places by holding a candlelight vigil tomorrow night. Now, this whole thing, again, is being done very, very tongue-in-cheek, just trying to have a little fun. Well, the story took on a life of its own. In fact, it's not only gone viral and is being talked about in our part of the world, it's gone nation and now worldwide. Now, I was told by someone in the building, someone smarter than me that actually reads the London Times, that this was covered by the London Times. You know, London, the big city in England. It was on Fox News, et cetera, et cetera. Well, this is the single perfect event to be covered by Steve Animal on our sister station, 98.7 Mountain Wild Wonderful Classic Rock. In fact, the Mountain, myself included, Ryan, will be there tomorrow night for the vigil for the soon-to-be-torn-down Hooters restaurant in Kanawha City. Now, this candlelight vigil starts at 6:30 tomorrow night. I have been in contact with one of the organizers of the event. Didn't know either one of these gentlemen, but I got to know him. Had a couple lengthy phone conversations yesterday with one of the guys organizing it. It's a guy named Leo Browning. And he is scheduled to join me on the show tomorrow to talk about this. And I know for a fact he's also going to be on Steve Animal's show tomorrow morning on 98.7 Mountain Wild Wonderful Classic Rock. Bottom line in all this is sometimes, folks, you just got to have a little fun. And I've seen chatter on social media. People say it's embarrassing to West Virginia, blah, blah, blah. You know, it's supposed to be a little fun. And I don't think that either one of these organizers, in talking to one of them, Leo, yesterday, I don't think he realized that it would be as big. He said, look, Dave, I liked it. I just wanted to have a little fun, gather some people together, talk about the good times that we had at Hooters over the years. That's pretty much it. And it is gone. I did a search, as I said, on social media. This story is huge. And it's going to be a big deal, apparently, tomorrow night, 6:30 at the old Hooters location in Kanawha City. And, yes, the Mountain will be there. Fun fact, I think I mentioned this on the show yesterday, Steve Animal from our sister station, 98.7 Mountain Wild Wonderful Classic Rock, did a live broadcast at Hooters the day it opened. And now he's going to close it down tomorrow night. All right. Quick says, Dave, Jimmy was probably just dodging potholes. Or it could have been a reaction to raw milk. All right. We got to go. Thank you so much to Ag Commissioner Kent Leonhart, Brad McElhaney, to Hoppies live at the Capitol coming up on tomorrow. We're going to talk more about this thing in Kanawha City with Hooters. District 2 Congressional Candidate Chris Walker is on the show tomorrow, as well as Hannah Gardner. I will see you tomorrow. Till then, have fun. And love somebody.
WCHSAM, W243DRFM Charleston, and W283AQ Cross Lanes, a WVRC media station. We're proud to live here too.